Hello, and welcome to Drop In and Give Us 10, the series to help you target your library fitness and start the new year right. We hope you've been able to join us for our previous four sessions, Well-Balanced, Options for Healthy Library Fitness, Strengthen Your Core, a robust warm-up to research instruction, Couch to 5K, resources to help you through the entire semester, and Intermittent Fasting, the extras that will really enhance your personal research fitness. Today's session will be Target Zone, services and offerings to target specialty needs. If you were not able to catch our previous sessions, no worries. Just start in today where you are, and you can catch up with the others at a later time. Today's session will be brought to you by Nikki Cannon-Retch, Lori Gwinnett, and Autumn Johnson. We will be your fitness coaches to walk you through the special services and offerings to target those real specialty needs for faculty and research. Our first session is going to target open educational resources, or OER as they're often called. OER are any types of resources that you use to supplement your courses that are usually licensed under a special Creative Commons license. This allows the resources to be free or extremely low cost for your students. OER is one of the few initiatives that supports all of the strategic pillars of the university. Your library champion is myself, Nikki Cannon-Retch. I work in the Henderson Library on the Statesboro campus, but I'm available for the entire Georgia Southern community. My email is available to you on this page, underneath the awesome Bitmoji image, where we're feeling the burn of OER helping us with all of our course resources. There is a special library guide created so you can learn about OER, help locate OER, and stay up to date on any OER news. It's available at the URL underneath this section. If you've heard of ALG or Affordable Learning Georgia, you know that they supply grants to support OER in your courses. Some of these grants are upwards to $20,000. ALG usually has at least two rounds per academic year. Please contact me if you have any questions or want to consider applying for an ALG grant, or you can also find information on the same library guide. As usual, I'll be offering workshops throughout the semester on OER. These include everything from the very basics of what OER are to how OER can be used to help support diversity and inclusion in your coursework. All of these workshops count towards CTE badging system. Also be on the lookout for a new self-paced course that will be available in Folio, and this course will also count towards the CTE badging system. All in all, if you have any questions at all or want to really work your OER knowledge, please contact me, Nikki Cannon-Retch. Again, the email is on this page, and I'm going to turn it over to our next coach now.
Our second target area is government information. Hi, I'm Lori Gwinnett, the Government Information Librarian at Henderson Library in Statesboro. I'm here to help you target government resources for enhanced research fitness. We have federal and state government collections, but I can also assist with international and local government questions. Zach S. Henderson Library is an 80% selective federal depository library and has been since 1939. This means we have an agreement with the Government Publishing Office to house and make available materials published in the scope of the Federal Depository Library Program, or FDLP. Henderson Library agrees to support the collection by providing a government information librarian who serves as coordinator for the collection and also a specialist in assisting with government information needs. We have bulletins, professional papers, annual reports, and many topical publications from the USGS, NASA, the Department of Labor, Department of Defense, Treasury, and more. Many government entities offer portals to their information, such as OSTI.gov for science, Fraser for business, and Congress.gov. Since 2001, Henderson Library has been one of three University System of Georgia institutions serving as state repositories for government publications. Popular Georgia government information sources include annual reports for each agency in the state, and recent years of those materials are available on the website open.georgia.gov. Remember that Georgia is an open record state. We also have a robust collection of Georgia DOT publications, state legislative information, executive orders, and other publications from Georgia government agencies. Several state websites are listed in our databases under G for Georgia. These collections mean that we have a rich store of historical primary materials for you and your students. But all government information is not historical. I have documents for everyone. Don't think I have materials related to your class? Think again. Whether it's census data or the congressional record, congressional hearings, statistics from one of the many surveys conducted by the Census Bureau for the Departments of Education, Labor, or Justice, that's all government information. We also have the Federal Communications Commission record, nuclear regulatory reports, and all kinds of government information. Take a look and let me know how I can assist. We can work together to incorporate these into your classes. I am your resource for government-related research questions, for collection development regarding these sources, and for information literacy instruction in any discipline concerning government information. With notice, my colleagues can also incorporate government documents into their broader instruction for your classes. I can speak to your class about specific types of government information for as long or short a session as you need for your assignment. I can demonstrate a particular resource that you want students to use or help with citing government documents using your preference of citation style. I'm available for virtual consultations by phone, chat, email, or video meeting. Remember, my email has one N and two T's, unlike Button Gwinnett or Gwinnett County here in Georgia. I look forward to working with you.
Our third target area is Georgia Southern Library's Special Collections. Hi, my name is Autumn Johnson. I am one of the Special Collection Librarians based on the Statesboro campus. Special Collections has been established to collect, organize, preserve, and make available materials of permanent institutional and historical value to our university and local communities. Collections span both the Henderson Library in Statesboro and Lane Library on the Armstrong campus. Materials include personal papers, organizational records, photographs, campus publications, ephemera, rare books, and digitally born materials. The Zach S. Henderson Library Special Collection houses materials related to the history of Georgia Southern Statesboro campus and the Southeast Georgia community, including the counties of Bullock, Screven, Liberty, Candler, Tatnall, and Effingham. Our teaching rare books collection is also housed here. Formerly the Armstrong State University Archives and Special Collections, Lane Library Special Collections houses the institutional records of Armstrong State University and materials related to the history of Georgia Southern's Armstrong campus. Lane Library Special Collection also includes the Florence Powell Minus Room. It's a collection boasting materials by Savannah authors and those concerning the coastal Georgia region. All special collection items are described in Gilfine, the library's catalog. The catalog provides summary descriptions of holdings, many of which are more fully described in separate finding aids. Finding aids are linked to catalog records, but can also be found in digital commons, along with our digitized and digitally born collections. Library staff provide access to special collection materials and research assistance in person by appointment or by email, phone, fax, or Zoom. The Plan Your Research page on our website shared previously will walk you through the appointment request process, registration requirements, as well as our reading room rules. In addition, special collection librarians offer instructions on a variety of topics, including an overview of a special collections archive, the handling of rare materials in different formats, conducting original research using primary sources, and visual and archival literacy topics. A session can be tailored to your needs. We can also work with you to produce course-specific projects using our own collections. To schedule one of these sessions or to learn more about special collections, contact us by email or phone, or feel free to reach out to one of the special collections librarians on either campus directly. Caroline Hopkinson is based on the Armstrong campus, or you have myself, Autumn Johnson, on Statesboro's campus. You can also reach out to your liaison librarian for any assistance you may need. Thank you so much for attending Target Zone Services and Offerings to Target Specialty Needs, the fifth and final Drop In and Give Me 10 workshop. Later in the semester, we will offer synchronous Zoom sessions on these same topics, giving you an additional opportunity to ask us any questions you may have about these topics. In the meantime, please take a moment to take our survey at bit.ly/dropin10. Let us know what you thought of this series, share your contact, and receive a special thank you gift from us. If you have any questions, feel free to email any of our email addresses you see there. Thank you, Eagles. Have a great semester.